As we get older, our health becomes a little bit more important to our lives, but it also becomes a lot more expensive. Fortunately, there are health insurance plans that help us financially, and people like Tricia San Diego, certified health education specialist on AARP's education and outreach health team, that can help give us some advice. Hey, Tricia, welcome back to the show.
Hi, Mishi. Thanks for having me again.
All right, we're talking insurance today, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why is insurance, why is this topic important to you as an AARP advisor?
Sure. We just want to educate people on the health care law. It's also known as the Affordable Care Act. There's some great benefits and protections, and then there's also some deadlines that people need to be aware of for open enrollment.
Okay. So. And as far as I know, the Filipino community or the Asian community is kind of underrepresented, right?
Mm-hmm.
Konti lang yung sa amin yung nag-enroll na.
Right.
Right?
Yes.
So nationwide. Do you know the percentage of that?
I don't know off the top of my head, but there's still a lot more people who are uninsured and that need more coverage.
Okay. So especially speaking for our Canadians out there who might not know all the details
mm-hmm.
about the Affordable Care Act, what are some things that have to be covered?
Sure.
When you sign on?
Well, there's essentially 10 essential health benefits. They're called EHBs that are now covered through the plan. Things like hospital visits, doctor's visits, maternity newborn care, mental health. Well, those are all new benefits that have to be covered in the plan.
Wow, that's great.
Mm-hmm.
So they, I mean, no matter what plan you purchase, at the very minimum, they
mm-hmm.
have those things,
yes,
right?
The private plan.
And this is, I think, the best and most important thing for those who are over 50. You don't need, I mean, you cannot be refused for a pre-existing condition. In other words, if
yeah.
you're already sick, they can't be like, oh, no, we're not going to cover you.
Right. The law says you cannot be denied coverage for having a pre-existing condition, and you can't be charged more either if
right.
you become sick all of a sudden.
Yeah. And so, I mean, as we get older, we also get sicker. So
right.
this is really great news.
Yes.
For people out there.
Mm-hmm.
So what if we have Canadians, and when is the open enrollment period starting?
Open enrollment starts November 15th of 2014, and it goes into February 15th of 2015.
So from November 15th of this year
mm-hmm.
to February
15th.
To February 15th.
2015.
Next year. So you can mm-hmm. do it over Halloween or Thanksgiving
yeah.
or Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
What if we have Canadians who are super excited and they want to enroll right now? They don't want to wait for November 15th.
Well, that is the open enrollment period, the official period. You can qualify in certain circumstances to enroll outside of that, and that's called the special enrollment period, but you have to have a qualifying life event. So things like a birth or adoption of a child, loss of coverage, or a relocation out of the area or out of the state.
Okay, so that's something that you just need to research on
yeah.
and make sure that you qualify for.
Mm-hmm.
What if you have signed on during the open enrollment period and then realized, oops, mali, I got the wrong plan, I want to do this plan instead?
Sure, that happens. I think you can change as long as your coverage hasn't started yet. Your coverage effective date is the date that your coverage starts. So as long as it hasn't started yet during the open enrollment period, you can still switch plans. But if it has already started, you do have to wait till the open enrollment period next year, or you can qualify for a special enrollment period.
Okay, so but then that's kind of dicey, right? Because
yeah.
if you don't actually do an enrollment during the open enrollment period, like mm-hmm. you said, there are deadlines.
Yes.
What are the penalties for that?
There's a penalty if you don't have coverage. In 2015, it's $325 for the year, or
mm-hmm.
2% of your yearly household income, whichever is greater.
Yikes.
Yeah, and
that
it goes
gets
up every year.
That gets higher every year. So
yes.
it actually becomes more expensive not to be enrolled.
Yes.
After a certain
for
point.
For some people. Mm-hmm.
Right? Okay, this is for our TNT Canadians out there. If you're an undocumented Filipino and you're mm-hmm. living in the United States,
mm-hmm.
can you get coverage through the Affordable Care Act?
No, only non-citizens living in the United States legally, also known as lawfully present immigrants, are able to purchase through the health insurance marketplace.
Okay, so undocumented,
they're not able to purchase.
Sorry. Okay. Well, this is a lot to cover, Tricia, and I'm sure that people out there still have a lot of questions or want to see if they qualify for different things.
Yeah, sure.
So where can they go to find more information?
They can go to healthlawanswers.org. There's a wonderful website there. You can get a customized report about all your health law questions.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us
thank
again.
So
I
much.
Really appreciate you coming all the way from Washington, D.C.
Thank you.
With your family and your baby. It's awesome to have
Thanks.
You on the show.
Thank you.